Welcome back. Now, the strength of associations is that members can always be organized and as such break into available markets and with quality products. This is a story of Eco Honey producers from Hoima, whose leader says that as soon as they abandoned individual production, they have been reaping big. Despite the challenges, the future looks bright for these people. Here is how to make money.
I'm Mugisa Daudi from Hoima, and I'm standing in for Hoima Eco Honey Enterprise, and it is kind of a marketing setup to market the bee products. Bee products like honey, as you can see, beeswax, then here I have propolis. There are other products like bee venom, which don't have pollen, which they collect from plants, but that one we have not yet reached the stage of collecting because it needs a lot of machinery. But for the time being, we encourage the farmers or the beekeepers to bring us the honey when it is in the comb, so that we can extract ourselves to maintain the quality. In that case, the farmers or the beekeepers have, we want them to be organized in a kind of association, and we encourage them to have the Hoima Eco Honey suppliers as an association, yet is in the making. So far, we are able to pack this amount, this quality of honey, and it is, you know, the good thing with honey, you don't add anything. Once you extract it from the comb, it is ready for consumption. We make sure we don't adulterate it. By adulteration, by meaning that adding any other foreign body, water or what, something like that. So in that way, we have reached this level and it is selling well. We say question now the quantities that are disturbing us. Then propolis is a gummy substance. The bees collect from trees which have gummed. For instance, if you take a bark tree, mutuba, you know when that gummy shows. The bees will collect it to go and seal the cracks of the hive or some gaps. If the entrance is large, they will build something that is gummy. That's what we call propolis. That one we just collect it. The big quantities, we just dissolve it in certain high percentage, maybe alcohol, something like that, or ethanol, something. It takes a long process, it's about 3 months or so, to get out this kind of thing. This one is antiviral, antibacterial, anti whatever most of those disease-causing germs. To the extent, as for these days, this is a cousin of COVID-X, if you have heard. It has helped many people in that time of what to clear this cough and the like, then the sort of stomach upsets. Even it can cure wounds. So you find that one is very, very necessary to have in the home. You know, when something is done individually, there is a lot of variation. So we train these people. It is easier to train them when they're in groups. But when it is an association also, it gives us actual money to get quantities of these products so that we can have a bigger, better market. Other than having one farmer in a place, then he brings, when he's not coming, and we cannot visit each and every farmer in their homes. But when they're in an association, we tend to train them easily, and they also, they can use their association to get loans or things like that, some other services like that. So that is why we encourage them to get in groups or associations, and that's when they can access some services. You know, the methods of extraction vary. In fact, we take them through training to handle honey as food, and to handle also to keep the quality constant. We just need them to follow certain methods, other than doing everyone does his. And in that case, we emphasize on cleanliness. and the purity of honey, so that, you know, once honey is not adulterated, it can keep for long without going bad. So for the question of giving them training services and maybe also accessing the market, it is easier when they are in a situation like that one. As you may hear, sometimes they can even get loans, or it is easier to get loans and pay back. If, for instance, if they are in circles or something like that, it would be easier for them to... It is yet a problem. In fact, I could say it is an uphill task. You know, beekeeping as per se, it's not quite like almost like these other traditional agricultural activities. People, for instance, when you talk of maize, very many people know how to produce maize. If you talk of matoke, people have known how to produce matoke for long. But this beekeeping is not for everybody. Some people fear bees naturally, they fear bees. And others who have now started coming it, they used to get honey for just little consumption. But when it is now becoming commercial, we need it in quantities. That's why we are trying to emphasize, let them together so that we can increase on the quantities and then continue supplying and what. And as we are looking, if we don't really increase on quantities, then things we may not meet the goals.
Let's talk about foreign trade. Let me ask this question. Why do you think our manufacturers or people like you have not been able to really export to these markets that everyone talked about?
There are many factors, but some of them have not really been aware. That we need to create an awareness that foreign trade is for even us. Well, we used to think that foreign trade is for bigger companies. And when I look at myself in comparison with a company, how can I take things to Nigeria? When I hear of Nigeria, I don't even... And when I look on the map, I say, I can't afford. And when I talk of Kenya, I say, hey, Kenya, those are ahead of us. But when you think of the quantities, you practice, we say, hey, we have got some tons of honey. For example, I used to give an example when I'm training some people, say, have you ever seen a drum full of water? Yes. Can you imagine a drum full of honey? Some said, a drum? No. I said, now, how many jerry cans go in a jerry can? In the 12. Said, if I arrange 12 jerry cans of honey here, that's already a drum. He said, by the way, it can happen. So in that way, people are not very aware that they can do it. Yet we have the means. And then when we go to awaken people, the methods they are dealing with the agriculture, they just focus on one thing. If it is coffee, but the bees collect the nectar from the coffee, the nectar from other plants, which are not even cultivated. And we have the chances of very good vegetation, which have plants which produce nectar. So we encourage them to get in the venture, and people are waking up. And that's why you see now we are getting on market. In those days, it would be difficult to find this one in a local grocery, might be in Hoima.
That's right, but now you have them.
But you say, hey, you mean Hoima, we can produce this?
Yeah.
Then even the other place, you say, hey, even us. So when people are awakened and they are united, then we can make it. Well, the government have tried to at least to enlighten people. Before I came to this one, I've been working in the government also. My role was to train beekeepers. That's what I specialized in. Now when I retired, I said, no, let me go. Because there were three major things, the training, and then the production, then marketing. So the marketing part was a bit also funny. So when I retired, I said, no, let me go on the marketing part of it. So those who are still in service, they will train the beekeepers on how to do it. But when they produce it, where is the market? Said the market is there, but there's nothing to sell. That's why you don't see it. But now they have started things and said, meaning you can say, now they just come in like that. So the government, if it increases on training other people, producing people who can train the farmers, and then they put in the access, at least accessibility to the markets, it is easier. There are many factors also involved. When you hear of environmental degradation or environmental destruction, it is also another determining factor. The bees collect the this honey from the vegetation we have, which will include the farm products and the natural other products. But if we mishandle them like this one, now we are misusing the chemicals, spraying anyhow, and at times even we kill the bees and like. So if the government can focus on that one and rectify the situation, yeah, we can maintain the flow of the honey. But well, I don't know now the strategies. Much as I got out of the system, we would just really advocacy, please do not kill the bees, do not avoid this. Even you find that when you are going to buy these chemicals, they will say, less toxic to bees. That thing is very important, but some people don't bother about it. What do you mean toxic to bees? So in the agriculture or whatever practices, we must be also very vigilant to save the bees, and then we can increase in our production of honey and other products. I'm Mugisa Daudi. I'm with the Hoima Eco Honey Enterprise.
Now, on our personal finance tonight, we look at tips for better financial health.
Tips to have better financial health. 1. Review your investments. It's critical that you review your portfolio periodically to assess the status of your assets, how these are maturing, and to keep an eye on your cash flow. With age, your investment portfolio will also change in keeping with your risk profile. 2. Examine unnecessary expenses. Examine unnecessary expenses. One of the major focuses of a review is to understand our spending patterns. While we may aim to follow preset spending goals, most of us are often unaware of our actual buying habits. This is usually why our savings at the end of the month are sometimes less than expected. 3. Strengthen emergency funds. The last 2 years have showed us the importance of savings and a nest egg that can help you through the tough times. An emergency fund is designed to provide us with the financial fallback in case of an adverse event, such as a sudden loss of income. It can also include unplanned big expenses, such as major repairs to your car. And 4. Review your debt and rework your budget. A debt may seem like a heavy burden, but it is often a necessary part of our modern life. And in some cases, it may even be better than making heavy cash payments for every purchase. That said, it's always better to know your debts at the beginning of the year.
If you've been following our personal finance segment, we usually bring to you some of the tips that will help you excel in business. And one thing I learned by myself is that debt is not always bad. It only becomes bad if you use it the wrong way, but a debt that you use to develop your business and your own life is always very good, so do not fear to borrow, but rather borrow for the right cause. We now move on to the Forex and Money Market Report. What a week! But as a business person, you have to always know that there are good times and bad times, and use the good times to maximize your profits and use all the opportunities to the maximum. But also don't panic in the bad times, because if you have a stable business throughout the opportunities time, you can then wait for the brighter day to come ahead. Thanks so much for watching tonight. You can get in touch with us on social media. My handle is at Viola Kusasira on every platform. And together with the team, we wish you the best, but also don't lose hope. I'll see you next time. Good night.